internal events can be controlled, but if it's an external events, it is not in your control. But you have response in your control to a great extent, and that can shape your outcome. Your outcome can either be good, very good, or it can be, you know, as it is. So there is something which is in your purview. And all this time, what came to my mind is that keep your mind above matter. It's easier said than done. You know, keep your mind above matter is extremely important. And your emotional, you know, this particular thing is to settle it in and have your mind above matter. That really helped me a lot to know, have that sense of awareness and sense of acceptance that there are things which you can't do, but let's go ahead in life. So then I proceeded in my journey. I went to Bangladesh, and then, as you rightly said, COVID was just evolving. We were not knowing anything about what is it. We were one of the, we are one of the leading suppliers of medical oxygen in the country, in Bangladesh, and we were going all well. And we had another plant which was mothballed. We started that plant so that the combined capacity of both the plants, we can easily do it. The operations team got together. So slowly we started seeing that April, May ho gaya, that was fine. Then the first peak came during the month of August. August 2020 last year was a time when there was the first peak of COVID in Bangladesh here. And we managed the circumstances. We managed it well. And the whole thing was, our focus was on patient safety. Patient priority is the topmost. And that's what we told the whole organization. And the whole company, as a leadership, I have to communicate and say that this is what it is. We have to focus on the patients and ensure that all the medical colleges which are being serviced by Linde Bangladesh, they don't go dry of oxygen. So we were working round the clock, and the plans, the operations team put in their immense efforts. You know, round the clock, you can imagine there is no shutdown, nothing. It's going round the clock all through the process, and we went through it. It was all the time when the SOP guidelines were coming into place. And Linde has one of the finest COVID guidelines, you know, the way we need to operate, the way we need to have the protocols which are in place. All those things we had very well crystallized. And we had disseminated that information to the lowest, you know, at the worker level. Everyone knows it in their own language. So that was all done.
Wow.
So this is what was actually going through, you know, and this was the first phase of our whole event. And, you know, the thing is that we were all working as a team. The teamwork, extremely important, and, you know, the operations and all. This was okay. This was all fine. Then struck in December. In December, the medical oxygen demand went up to 100 tons per day, 85 tons, 100 tons, that was a requirement. And you know, as Murphy's law says, we had a technical glitch in one of our plants. So we realized that, you know, we didn't have much of stock left of medical oxygen. Kam se kam do teen din chalega, that's what we could realize. And it is at that particular moment that we realize that we have to take, you know, something which is urgent decisions we need to take. And decision is extremely important. You can't have the normal decision-making process. We engaged with the authorities, our team, you know, the medical, our hospital healthcare head, Mushfiq, and the deliver head, and also the admin. We all got together. As a team, we went and approached to the health ministry, the government officials. And, you know, during this particular process, I was remote. I was in India during this particular time when it was, you know, March 26 to June 6 was complete month. So I had come during that phase. And it was all through remote leadership that I was talking every day. And we went to the health ministry. We got the permissions from them. And the ministry also realized that we have to take action. So we had to reach out to our counterparts in Linde India. And with Linde India, the management, we reached out to them, and with Molloy at the helm of office, we said that we need to get medical oxygen from India. So fine. There were 45 tankers which had to be put in the circuit, and each tanker is around 15 tons. So you can imagine 45 tankers in the circuit every day plying. We had established a green corridor. Otherwise, in the usual process of customs, it takes time of clearance from one country to the other. But we got great support from the health ministry and the government of Bangladesh, as well as from the Indian counterparts. And we could actually manage this circuit of tankers coming in, not only to the border, but into the heart of Bangladesh to our plant with escort. And this is the first historical decision which we took. So you have to take, you know, decisions which are out of box. And that's something, you know, during a crisis, we realized that you can't go with the normal flow, Prashant. We established a green corridor. The management was very clear, and we ensured that there was no, you know, nothing happening in the hospitals. Everything was okay, and we went through this process. Whenever a crisis comes, it realizes that what are you made up of? Are you made up of steel or you're made up of plastic? And crisis reveals your team culture. And that's something which I told my team, that we are in a national emergency. Guys, we all need to pull up our socks. We need to, you know, devote time over here. This is a national emergency. And you, whatever you're doing today, you're going to share the stories later on. You will be a storyteller later on. Because being a leading supplier of medical oxygen in the country, you're the entire, you know, you feel proud that you're carrying this burden, but it gives a lot of responsibility on your shoulders. And when we started getting these tankers, you know, Prashant, coming in from India, there was a lot of support from the cluster leaderships, you know, Mahase, you know, like from the delivery team, from the finance team, procurement, all teams are working in complete symphony. And we managed that particular crisis, which happened in, you know, the 1st of December. We did it, operations team, everyone worked together. We did something which was not done before, like getting some parts from Germany by chartered flights, which has not happened before. So the whole, we were all possessed, because I have seen something, grief in my, you know, time with my mother, that she was having a breathing problem and all. And my whole thing was to ensure that nothing happens to the people here. And that was something as an anchor for me. And I drew the same thing. It's very easy to say, because during this process, the team morale had to be kept high. You know, so all my 18 leaders, the functional leaders, the business leaders, we had to actually get every morning. There was a religious call. We used to have a call in the morning, calling in the afternoon, evening. And then we used to have a WhatsApp chat group. Raat ko 12:30 baje tak we used to call. And then 4:30, aaj ka kya distribution plan hai? Everything used to be there, because your whole dependency is there. In the hospital, the supplies, the requirement of medical oxygen was going so high. You were not in that control. And these things happened. So that wave happened in December, Jan. Then came the wave of July. And when it happened in July, it reached 170 tons requirement. A plant is 90 tons. Your production capacity is 90 tons. And, you know, you need a demand which is reaching 170 tons. And then we realized, for the whole country, you know, it is something like incremental changes cannot make a propeller engine into a jet engine. If you make incremental changes, you cannot change a propeller flight into a jet engine. You need to do something which is, you know, you have to take a quantum leap. And that's when the whole transformation we had to do. We had witnessed the Oxygen Express in India, the way, you know, it has helped the ferrying oxygen from the east to the various parts. And Linde had done it extremely well. So we caught, you know, that particular thing. And we thought that this is the thing we have to do for getting by train from India to Bangladesh. But it is a cross country. It involves multiple bodies. And that's when our team from Bangladesh got to the ministry, and they gave the scope document. This is what we plan to do. And we can foresee. And this is where, you know, the proactiveness comes in, where we have to do, depending upon the infection rate and understanding how much is going to be the medical oxygen, where are the new installations coming up. We looked at the whole wave, and then we decided that, you know, we will get in by train. And they said, okay, train in Bangladesh. There was a lot of logistics things. But we got great support from the government of Bangladesh and government of India. Then it was a complete logistical things to manage from Linde India, our team, as well as Linde Bangladesh, Indian Railways, Bangladesh Railways, and all the supply, you know, the chain partners who are there, the customs, the banking authorities, to ensure it is totally streamlined. And the team did a fantastic, you know, collaboration out here. And this is the first time in the history we had this Indo-Bangla Oxygen Express, which brought oxygen from India to Bangladesh. So it's all historical. And I said my team, the team felt proud because they could see it in the television. They could see the family seeing it. And someone's family member is there in the hospital, and they feel proud that, you know, we are doing it. And the whole matter of the national pride. And I told my team that whatever we are doing it for the nation.